Shem is a short for Seamus, as Jem is jokey for Jacob. A few toughnecks are still gettable, who pretend that, aboriginally, he was of respectable stemming. He was an outlex between the lines of Raganar Blaubarb and Horold Hairwire, and an in-law to Captain the Honourable and Reverend Mr. Birdwood to Trop Blog, was among his most distant connections. But every honest-to-goodness man in the land of the space of today knows that his back life will not stand being written about in black and white. Putting truth and untruth together, a shot may be made at what this hybrid actually was like to look at. Shem's bodily get-up, it seems, included an adze of a skull, an eight of a lark's eye, the whole of a nose, one numb arm of a sleeve, 42 hairs off his uncrown, 18 to his mock lip, a trio of barbels from his megagig chin, Salmon's son, the wrong shoulder higher than the right, all ears, an artificial tongue with a natural curl, not a foot to stand on, a handful of thumbs, a blind stomach, a deaf heart, a loose liver, 2/5 of 2 buttocks, 1 gleestine avodu porter for him, a man root of all evil, a salmon kelt's thin skin, eel's blood in his cold toes, a bladder tristended, so much so that young Master Shemmy, on his very first debauch, at the very dawn of proto-history, seeing himself such and such, when playing with thistle words in their garden nursery, grief atrophio, at Fig Street 111, Shoveland Old Holland. Would we go back there now for sounds, pillings and scents? Would we now for anise and anise? Would we for full score 8 and a Loretta? For 12 blocks 1 bob? For 4 testers 1 groat? Not for a dinar. Not for Joe. Dick Titled to, of all his little brethren and suisterines, the first riddle of the universe, asking, when is a man not a man? Telling them, take their time, young fries, and wait till the tide stops. For from the first, his day was a fortnight. And offering the prize of a bittersweet crab, a little present from the past, for their copper age was yet unminted, to the winner. One said, when the heavens are Quakers. A second said, when Bohemian lips. A third said when hold hard a jiffy. When he is a Gnostic and determined to. The next one said, when the angel of death kicks the bucket of life. Still another said, when the wine's at wit's ends. And still another, when lovely woman stoops to conk him. One of the littlest said, me, Sam, when Papa papered the harbour. One of the wittiest said, when he ate ye ablukuchen and he smears his elves azuchen. Still one said, when you are old, I'm grey, fall full with sleep. And still another, when we deader Walkner. And another, when he is just only after having been semicized. Another, when yea, he hath no mananas. And one, when dose pigs, they begin now, they will flies up into the luft. All were wrong. So Shem himself, the doctator, took the cake. The correct solution being, I'll give it up when he is a... Yours till the rending of the rocks, Sham. Sham was a sham, and a low sham, and his lowness creeped out first via foodstuffs. So low was he, that he preferred Gibson's tea-time salmon tinned, as inexpensive as pleasing, to the plumpest roe-heavy lax, or the friskiest par or smolt troutlet that ever was gaffed between Leakslip and Island Bridge. And many was the time he repeated in his botulism that no jungle-grown pineapple ever smacked like the whoppers you shook out of Ananias's cans, Finlater and Gladstone's, Corner House, England. None of your inch-thick, blue-blooded balaclava fried at Belief steaks, or juice-jellied eggs of the Grex's molten mutton, or greasly, gristly grunters go upons, or slice upon slab of luscious goose bosom, with lump after load of plum pudding stuffing, all a swim in a swamp of bog oak gravy, for that Greek-hearted ewed. Roast biff of old Zealand, he could not a-touch it. See what happens when your somatophage merman takes his fancy to our vegetarian swan. He even ran away with himself, and became a far soonerite, saying he would far sooner muddle through the hash of lentils in Europe than meddle with Erland's split little pea. Once, when among those rebels in a state of hopelessly helpless intoxication, the Pisivore strove to lift a citron peel to either nostril, hiccuping, apparently impromptued by the hybrid he had with his glottal stop, that he cuckold flourish forever by the smell, as the zedron, like a cedar of the founts on mountains with Limanon of Lebanon. Oh, the lowness of him was beneath all up to that sung to. No liked by like fire water, or first served first shot, or gullet burned gin, or honest brew barred beer either. Oh dear, no. Instead, the tragic jester sobbed himself way whingingly sick of life, and some sort of a rhubarbarous, modern yellow-green, funko-blue, windigot, dying applejack, squeezed from sour grapefruits. And to hear him twixt his sentimental cup-slips, when he had gulfed down much too many gourds of it, retching off to almost as low with swillers, who always knew notwithstanding when they had had enough, and were rightly indignant at the wretch's hospitality, when they found to their horror they could not carry another drop, and it came straight from the noble white fat Joe, open wide sat Jojo. Or why hide that, Jojo, the wine vat, of the most serene majesty as archdiocese? If she's a duck, she's a duchess, and when she has a fair bore, it's not her fault now, is it? Archduchips, funny you're grinning at, fancy you're in her yet, Fanny Urania. Ain't that swell, hey? Piamengro. Talk about lowness. Any dog's quantity of it visibly oozed out thickly from this dirty little blacking beetle. For the very fourth snap, the Tullock Turnbull girl, with her cold blood Kodak, shotted the as yet unremunerated national apostate, who was cowardly gun and camera shy, taken what he fondly thought was a shortcut to care-fear soak Americas, via the ship steam Pridewin, after having buried a hatchet not so long before, by the wrong goods exeunt, nummer desh to tren, into patata papaveris, fruiterers and musical florists, with his chow chavi, sar shinshillipen. She knew the vice out of Bridewell was a bad fast man by his walk on the spot. John's is a different butcher's. Next place you're uptown, pay him a visit, or better still, come to buy. You will enjoy cattleman's spring meat. John's is now quite divorced from baking. Fattens, kills, flays, hangs, draws, quarters and pieces. Feel his lambs, X. Feel how sheep, XX. His liver too is great value, a speciality, XXX. Communicated. Around that time, moreover, one generally, for love of money, hoped, or at any rate suspected among morticians, that he would early turn out badly, develop hereditary pulmonary TB, and do for himself one dandy time, nay of a pelting night blanketed creditors, hearing a coarse song and splash off Eden Quay, sighed and rolled over, sure all was up, but though he fell heavily and locally into debit, not even then could such an antinomian be true to type. He would not put fire to a cerebrum. He would not throw himself in Liffey. He would not explode himself with pneumatics. He refused to suffocate himself with a sod. With the foreign devil's leave, the frayed-born fraud diddled even death. Anzi, cabled but shaking the worth out of his mouth, got a costa leparello, sassus Christ. From his near republican asylum to his Jonathan for a brother. Here to guy, gone to Murray, we're splotched, do something fireless, and had answer, inconvenient, David. You see, chaps, it will trickle out, freaksly, of course, but the tom and the shorty of it is, he was, in his bardic memory, low. All the time he kept treasuring with condign satisfaction each and every crumb of trek talk, covetous of his neighbour's word, and if ever, during a Monday conversazione, commoted in the nation's interest, delicate tibbets were thrown out to him, touching his evil courses by some well-wishers, vainly pleading, by scriptural argument, with the obrobrious papist, about trying to brace up for the kiddos of the thing scallywag, and be a man instead of a dem scrounger desh it all, such as, pray, what is the meaning, saucy, of that continental expression, if you ever came across it? We think it is a word transpiciously like, can I? Or, did you anywhere kennel on your Gullible's travels, or during your rural troubadouring, happen to stumble upon a certain gay young nobleman whimpering to the name of Low Swine, who always addresses women out of the one corner of his mouth, lives on loans, and is furtive-free years of age, without one sigh of haste, like the supreme prig he was, and not a bit sorry, he would pull a vacant landlubber's face, root with earwaker's pencile on the outer of his loucher, and then lisping, the prattle-pate Parnella, to kill time, and swatting his dead best to think what under the canopies of Jansen's crest would any decent son of an Albio gentleman, who had been to an university, think, let a lent, hit a hint, and begin to tell all the intelligentsia admitted to that Tamalese, Sam Talese conclamazione, since still and before physicians, lawyers merchant, belfry politicians, agriculus manufraudurers, sacristanes of the Pure River Society, philanthropics lodging on as many boards around the panesthetic at the same time as possible, the whole lifelong shrine story of his entire low coronai existence, abusing his deceased ancestors, wherever the sods were, and one moment Tara booming great blunderguns, pah, about his far-famed fine papamore, Mr. Hum-Hum, whom history, climate, and entertainment made the first of his sept, and always up to debt, though heaven's ears how many fines he faces. And another moment vice and verses, croaking three jeers, pah, for his rotten little ghost of a peppy beg, Mr. Himmy Shimmy, a blighty, a reeky, a lighty, a scrapey, a babbly, a ninny, dirty seventh among thieves, an always bottom sawyer, till no one knowed how homely home could be, giving unsolicited testimony on behalf of the absent, as glib as Eve's water to those present, who meanwhile, with increasing lack of interest in his semantics, allowed various subconscious smickers to dribble slowly across their features, unconsciously explaining, for inkstands, with a meticulosity bordering on the insane, the various meanings of all the different foreign parts of speech he misused, and cuttlefishing every lie unshrinkable about all the other people in the story, living out, of course, for consciously, the simple wharf and plague and poison they had cornered him about, until there was not a snoozer among them, but was utterly undeceived in the heel of the reel by the recital of the rigmarole. He went without saying that the cull disliked anything anyway approaching a plain, straightforward, stand-up or knock-down row, and as often as he was called in to umpire any octagonal argument among slangwangers, the accomplished washout always used to rub shoulders with the last speaker and clasp-shakers, the hand-touch which is speech without words, and agree to every word as soon as half-uttered. Command me, your servant. Good, I revere you. How, my seer? Be drinking that. Quite truth. Gracias. I'm youth. See what I'm hearing? Also goods. Please it. Me sure? Be filling this. Quiso. You said it. A pass a fellow. Muchas gracias. Is there firing on me? Is there garlic on you? To your good self, your sulphur. And then at once focus his whole unbalanced attention upon the next octagonist, who managed to catch a listener's eye, asking and imploring him out of the piteous one-winker, Himoptesia diaduminos, whether there was anything in the world he could do to please him and to overflow his tumbled tantalizer for him yet once more. One hail cannon night, for his departure was attended by a heavy downpour, as very recently as some thousand rains ago, he was therefore treated with what closely resembled personal violence, being soggart all unsuspectingly through the deserted village of Tumblin-on-the-Leafy from Mr. Van Homry's house at 81 Bis Mabbott's Mall, as far as Greenpatch beyond the brick fields of Salmon Pool, by rival teams of slow spears, counter-quick climbers, who finally, as rarely they had been detained out rather latish, thought business hits business. They had better be streaking for home, after their Auburn to Auburn, with thanks for the pleasant evening, one and all disgustedly, instead of ruggering him back and awake, reconciled, though they were as jealous as could be cullions about all the truffles they had brought on him, to a friendship fast and furious, which merely arose out of the noxious pervert's perfect lowness. Again, there was a hope that people looking on him with the contempt of the contemptibles, after first giving him a roll in the dirt, might pity and forgive him, if properly deloused. But the pleb was born a quick low, and sank a lowing till he stank out of sight.